Here are five things to know about former South Carolina Governor Nikki Haley, who's running for the 2024 Republican presidential nomination. Haley highlights her background in accounting and her mid-career entry into politics to position herself as a political underdog.
She knows where she is in this race right now, right? She's not Donald Trump. She's not even second place like Ron DeSantis. She's here to work hard and to sell herself. That's something she's always done. Starting when she was in the State House in 2004, she had some big issues that she wanted to get across the finish line, but House leadership wasn't too keen on some of her issues, like on-the-record voting. So she decided to run for governor, right? Again, is she actually going to win governor? She's some, sophomore-type State House representative, and she's up against a congressman, a former lieutenant governor, a state attorney general, and then there's Nikki, who is what she always calls herself. And she won in that primary and eventually that race, too.
Haley's campaign focuses on the economy and foreign policy issues. Two of her main goals are cutting federal spending and boosting American businesses.
She continues to say that Washington needs a good accountant, and fiscal responsibility is definitely one of those issues she wants to see in play. She says a lot of these issues that we've gotten ourselves into when it comes to spending and the deficit is not just because of Democrats, but also because of Republicans. So we've seen her talk about those issues, and she said that she wants to see spending return to pre-COVID-19 levels if she got into office. She talks about all the time making small businesses better, making it easier for businesses to thrive in America, cutting red tape, cutting regulations. Again, she'll point to what she did in South Carolina in attracting more business.
Haley also served as the U.S. ambassador to the United Nations during the Trump administration, so she doesn't shy away from campaigning on international issues.
With the war in Ukraine and Russia and obviously the threat of China, what she routinely talks about on the campaign trail, she talks about these lofty international issues, which you typically didn't hear people talk about before on campaign trails, but she makes them interesting. She makes it digestible and understandable to folks about just how big this threat is from China and what would happen if Russia won the war in Ukraine if we didn't support them.
Haley supports gun rights and aligns with most traditional Republican viewpoints, calling for less involvement by the federal government.
She's very pro Second Amendment. She has obviously said a couple times that she's not big on red flag laws. She doesn't think that the government should intervene. She's really hands off, does not want the government doing too much here because she doesn't want them to say, you know, who can and who cannot have a gun.
Haley is anti-abortion, but says that abortion issues should be left to the states to decide.
What I'm very happy about is that once Roe was overturned, it took it from unelected justices and it put it back in the hands of the people.
When it comes to LGBTQ+ rights, Haley has taken a more conservative position than many of her competitors.
She's been big on when, like, Ron DeSantis came out with the Don't Say Gay law. She said that one didn't go far enough. You know, talking about sexual orientation and gender issues in elementary school, she said that should go further. She's against, you know, transgender student athletes at the high school and college level.
Haley originally backed Florida Senator Marco Rubio in 2016, before serving under Trump. She says Trump bears some responsibility for what happened on January 6th, and she supports the legitimacy of the 2020 election.
She came out against him after January 6th and the insurrection at the Capitol. She said that was not a great day, as Donald Trump continues to call it. She continues to call him out on certain things. She's not as direct as some folks are, but at the same time, she's just tired of commenting on every Trump drama.
Haley is the only leading GOP primary candidate that's a woman of color. But these aspects of her identity are not the focus of her campaign.
If you ask her, she'd say, no, it doesn't matter at all, because she never really leans into that aspect, right? So she was the first female governor in South Carolina in 2010. And she always says, okay, we got that out of the way. Let's focus on what we need to do. She doesn't dwell on it. And she's not Donald Trump. She doesn't have the baggage of Donald Trump. She's really working hard to press the flesh and get to know people and let them get to know her so they can see that there's a breath of fresh air out there, right? Some people even say that to her, you are such a breath of fresh air. We need someone different. We need someone younger, someone who's 51 compared to these folks in their 70s, which is why she's been pushing for mental competency tests to help, you know, make this a conversation, make this into more of a debate to show that you can have a younger leader that actually knows what they need to do.
Haley faces several other Republicans in the primary lead up to 2024, which the PBS NewsHour will profile. You can find those profiles at pbs.org/newshour or right here on our YouTube channel. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nicole Ellis.